Hello and welcome to This Week in the Garden. It's rainy again, so we're off the hay bale and back inside. But we're going to talk this week about potato towers. And that's kind of an interesting way to grow potatoes that I learned about this spring. And it was one of the first things that I wanted to try in the garden. Now, potatoes are an early season crop. You put them in the ground really early in February and March. They mature up until their harvest time, sometime in June or July. And usually, you'll know when they're ready to harvest, the leaves start to die off, the stems start to die off as well. So that's when you really go to harvest your potatoes. Now, traditionally, potatoes are grown in the ground, and you grow them in rows. And one of the issues with that is when you go to harvest them, you have to dig up the potatoes because they're growing underground. They grow off of the stem as these tubers. And so when you go to dig them up, a lot of times you end up damaging the potatoes with your shovel when you're digging in the ground. And so potato towers are an interesting way around that, where you grow your potatoes in upright towers that are made out of straw with a little bit of soil. And that way you can just take them, you can get them undone, all the soil and the straw falls out, and hopefully your potatoes fall out with them. Now, our potatoes aren't ready quite yet. We're still probably a few weeks away before harvest. But I'm going to show you kind of what I did to make my potato towers. Now, this isn't going to be a how-to video because I'm not sure that my potato towers are working that well. But I will talk about what I did along the way and some of the things I've learned for next year, because I think I will try this again, depending on how many potatoes I get this year. Now, the first thing I did to make my towers was I took some wiring. That was just fencing that I had from when I put up the fence for the garden. And I like it because it has a kind of wide screen that allows the potatoes to grow through that. So I took out the roll, I cut it to about 5 inches long, and then I coiled it to make that kind of cylinder tube. And then I realized that was a little bit tall for me, and I'm a pretty tall guy, but it was hard for me to reach the bottom. So I cut that in half. And that allowed the tower to be a little bit shorter, but it was more manageable for me to work with it. After I had that cut, I looped it together on the ends to make that cylinder, and then I put hay around the outside. Normally you would use straw, and I think that was my first mistake. I had issues finding straw, so I found hay, and I put it around the outside. Now hay is the cut grass part of the straw, so straw is like a wheat shaft. Hay, on the other hand, is something like Bermuda or fescue that's been cut and then baled. And the hay was a little bit more dense than the straw. And so I think my potatoes had some difficulties emerging through that hay. So anyways, I put the hay around the outside and then you put soil on the inside. And that's what your potatoes are going to put their roots into. So I did that. I put it for about a foot tall. And then I put my potatoes in the soil there. I went another foot up, put more potatoes, and then I covered it up on the top with some more soil and then some hay as well. I also added fertilizer along the way to the soil because potatoes like really rich, nutrient-filled soil. So I added a lot of fertilizer, just a generic 10-10-10 along the way, mixed that into the soil. But that was pretty much the creation of the potato tower. I want to take a second to talk about actually the planting of the potatoes, because they're a little odd if you've never planted them before. So you get a potato, and they call them potato seeds. They're usually smaller potatoes that you use to actually plant and become your potato plants. They already have usually eyes growing out of them, and that's the eye of the potato becomes the stem of the plant. Now, when you get them in the bag, what you want to do is process those potatoes. So you can cut them into chunks, and you want each chunk to have about 2 eyes on it. Now, when I cut mine, I basically cut them in half because I didn't have that many eyes on them. So you cut them in half to get you more potatoes that you can grow. So I did that, and then I let them harden over that cut area. You don't want to put that in the soil immediately because you might get diseases. So I let them harden for about 48 hours. And some people say put it the cut side up. Some people say put it cut side down. I did both of those and it didn't seem to matter. So you can do either of those, but that allows the plant to harden over before you actually put it in the soil. Now, when you put the plant in the soil, you want to make sure that the eyes are pointing outward. That's because those are the stems, so that's where the plants are going to grow from. That's where all your green material is, and it's going to want to go towards that light. So I put my potatoes kind of right along the edge of where the soil met the hay. And so I put kind of the part where the roots would come out of, the cut side usually, put that in the soil, and then I stuck the eyes pointing outwards, and then I usually put a little bit of hay around it just to kind of give them a head start. Now, I think if I had straw, the potatoes would have come out a little bit better because, like I said before, it's a little bit less dense. It's a little bit lighter than the hay. But also, I think when I do this again next year, what I'm going to do is stick the potatoes through the cage rather than doing it as layers, because I think my potatoes, once that soil settled, they might have gotten buried a little bit deeper. But that's really it for my potato tower experiment. We're still seeing how it's growing, and I've got some pictures to show you along the way. So hopefully you've seen that or seen it in my garden tour. But we'll let you know how it goes in the next few weeks once the plants start to die off, and we'll see what kind of harvest we get. If you have any tips for me or any questions, we've got a form you can fill out to let me know, and I'll include that. Also, take a look at this week's article, which if you're watching this on YouTube, I'll have the link so you can check that out on our website. But I've got a lot of the gardens that y'all submitted for our giveaway. So take a look at kind of what we have growing around the county. And with that, we'll see you next time on This Week in the Garden.